Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about what is the best modification to make your car faster, and we're going to do this using some math going around a track. It's going to be straight out of this book here, which I will include a link to in the video description. But essentially what we've got is we're going to have three different cars, and each of those cars is going to go around this track, and we're going to see what lap time they post. One of them is going to have new tires, one of them is going to have double the horsepower and double the torque of the original car, and we'll see which one is the fastest. And so this track here, what we've got going on, you've got two straights on each side here, and then two straights on each side here, and so each one of these is going to be 300 feet or about 90 meters, and each one of these longer straights is about 500 feet or 150 meters. Clearly I didn't draw too great to scale, but whatever, that's what our track looks like. We've got a width of about 30 feet or 9 meters, and we've got these corners here, so the total track length is about 2,250 feet or 685 meters. So you'll notice it is a fairly tight course, but you do have these decent straights to get up to speed. And so car number one, which is going to be our base car, our control essentially, it's able to accelerate at 0.3 Gs, which isn't all that quick. You know, pretty much any family sedan out there could probably hit that these days. It's able to brake at 1.1 Gs, which is pretty decent, and corner at 1 Gs, which is also pretty good. So, you know, typically your braking is going to be slightly higher than your cornering Gs, but essentially, so this is our control car. We're going to see how fast can it go around the track. You do all the math, and there's quite a bit of complicated math in order to get to these numbers, but like I said, it's all in that book, which I've linked in the video description, and you get the top speed on this straightaway of 73 miles per hour, or about 117 kilometers per hour, and the car is able to post a lap time of 27 seconds, 0.47. And so the thing is, we want to compare this now to if we were to upgrade to some new tires. Okay, so our vehicle with the new tires, it doesn't have any more power, so it's still going to be accelerating at the same 0.3 Gs. Braking, we're going to say, remains the same. Now, in reality, it would improve a bit, but just to keep the math simple, we're going to say braking stays the same. And cornering, we're going to go up from 1.0 Gs to 1.1 Gs. So a 10% improvement in the cornering force based on these new tires. That's something, realistically, if you were to get a nice compound versus a lower quality compound, or perhaps a summer versus an all season, you could easily get that difference of 10% in the cornering force. And so if we take this car and we now go around the track, our top speed is going to be 74.5 miles per hour, or about 120 kilometers per hour. So where does this improvement come from? Well, essentially, you're able to carry more speed in the corners. So when you start accelerating on the straight, you're going to be able to get to a higher speed, slightly higher, 74.5 miles per hour rather than 73. And just so it's clear, we are taking the racing line around this. So if you were to take the inside line, which is of course one path you could take, versus the outside line, the inside line will be slightly quicker than the outside, but taking the racing line on this track is going to give you about 3 seconds of improvement if you kind of, you know, cut these corners, you go wide, cut the corner, and then hit the apex, and then come back out wide. That's going to save you about 3 seconds going around the track, so that's the lap time we're going with. That's what this 27.47 comes from. So doing this with the car with better tires, we're going to get 26.34, or a difference of 1.13 seconds split versus our car without these tires. So we're able to shave off a second, 0.13, just by changing the tires on this, because we're able to carry more speed in these corners. Okay, now let's take a car and let's double its torque curve. Let's essentially just take that torque curve and shift it up twice whatever it is, and that will essentially double the horsepower as well. And so we're able to now accelerate at 0.6 Gs. Our braking is going to remain the same at 1.1 Gs. We don't have those nice tires, so we're still cornering at 1.0 Gs. So now our top speed on the track, because we've got so much more power in this engine, in this car, is going to be 84 miles per hour on these straights. You're going to be able to accelerate. That's the equivalent of 135 kilometers per hour. And this will give us a track time of 26 point, here's the magical moment, 53. So a split of 0.94 over the original car. So here's the crazy thing. We took a car, we doubled its horsepower, we sent it around this track. Yes, it is a tight track. If you were to have longer straights, You would have an advantage in a car with more power, but essentially the more turns a track has, the more advantage will be given to a car with nicer tires. And so what we're seeing here is that a car with nicer tires and half the horsepower, they're the exact same vehicle, this one just has half the power, is able to go around this track faster than a car with double the power and slightly worse cornering. And so this has a 10% improvement in tires, this has 100% improvement in power, and yet a 10% improvement is just as effective on this track. And that's crazy to think, and it shows you kind of the power of tires out there. This can also explain, you know, if you see a car that's, let's say, 50 grand, it's kind of heavy, it doesn't have that much power, but it's posting lap times like Ferraris on tracks, a lot of it's probably going to come down to the tires. And if you look at the tires, you'll probably notice a difference between whatever that car is and whatever the Ferrari is running, and notice that they've probably got a stickier compound, and that's how they're able to do it. Same thing could apply to autocross. If you've got really nice tires on your autocross car and there's more powerful, lighter weight cars out there, you know, you'll be able to kind of hang with them depending on their tires. If they've got crappy tires and a really nice car and you've got a crappy car with really nice tires, you'll be posting dramatically similar times. And that's one of the really cool things about tires. It's one of the most important upgrades you could ever do to make your car faster on a track. Now, yes, this requires corners, so in a straight line, you're not going to really gain any benefit unless, you know, you're traction limited because you have so much power. Now, one assumption that is made in doing the math of this is that when you are cornering, you're doing that at a constant speed. So you have a constant speed based on your lateral G's, and then you accelerate once you get to the point where you've straightened out. Then you get to a point and you start braking, and then you remain back at that constant speed that you can handle that corner, and then you accelerate, brake, corner, constant speed, and so on. So really, you know, the fastest lap time, you're going to be trail braking into that and then accelerating out. But essentially, the time won't be a huge difference. The other benefit, which isn't included in this, is that a car with better tires is going to have better braking. So this braking number would improve, and this time would actually be better than shown here because it would be able to brake later as a result of having better tires. So what are our conclusions? Well, based on this track right here, tires are 10 times as effective as adding power. So it's not to say that you shouldn't add power. You definitely should. It makes cars tons of fun. But you should think about tires initially. It's a great first modification, and it's really going to improve the way the car handles and how quickly it can corner. Additionally, as mentioned, our braking is going to improve, so it would actually be a better time than I've shown here. And, you know, one thing to think about is the more corners a track has, the tighter a track it is, the better times you're going to be able to post simply with better tires rather than having more power. Basically, the lesson here to learn is it's not necessary to go super fast, you just don't want to go super slow. And the way you avoid going super slow is maintaining a high speed by keeping a high speed in your corners. And so if you can maintain a high speed throughout the duration of the track, rather than slowing down a lot and then accelerating a lot, you're going to be able to post a better lap time. So thank you all for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below.